If you like to crush your opponent with a strong attack, then this video is right for you, because I'm going to teach you some theory with white pieces. And white can start the game with e4, the best by test, and now black can reply e5. This is one of the most common replies. Now we can develop the knight to f3, knight c6, and now bishop to c4, the Italian game. And here black have a lot of options, a lot of ways to play that, but one of them is knight to f6. This is a two knights defense. Why? Because black developed the two knights. For that reason, this is calling two knights defense. And we have a solid move here. If you like to play the Italian, a very solid opening, you can play d3 because you already developed the bishop and you're ready to develop the next one, the other bishop. But I'm not going to teach you this solid system. I'd like to teach you how to attack, and you can attack by this move, knight to g5. It's not good to develop to move your piece twice in the opening, but now you have the direct attack. You would like to capture an f7, right? And now if black doesn't know what to do, then he will face a lot of problems. But if he knows some theory, then he should play this move d5. This is a pawn sacrifice, and of course we can capture this pawn with this e takes d5. And now black can recapture that pawn, but already this is a very bad mistake. He falls into a trap. And now white can deliver a very strong attack. Of course you can pause the video and try to think. And the correct move here is to capture an f7, to scoop it up this pawn on f7, then deliver a double attack, because we're attacking the queen and the rook. And the system calls right liver attack. Of course white should capture here the knight, he doesn't have any other good move, and now we can deliver another double attack. We should develop the queen, and queen now attack the king and the knight on d5 as well. Black cannot do much here. For example, if he put the queen in between, then we can snap a bishop, you can capture the knight on d5, and this is a check. Another very bad variation is to hide in the corner, because now we can capture a knight, this is an extra knight. We deliver knight and we gain it back. And after this exchange, we can capture with the bishop. The only possible reply here is to put the bishop in between, but we can capture the bishop, and this is a beautiful checkmate. And it's very nice to deliver it in your games, right? So the only move after this queen to f3 move is to play king to e6. And now we have a very strong pin here. We sacrifice the knight, but white have a fantastic initiative. In order to increase the pressure, we should develop the knight. And now we are attacking on this poor knight on d5 with three pieces, with bishop, knight and queen. And now I'm going to show you this move in this particular game, knight c to e7. And in the next video, I'm going to teach you what to do after this reply, knight c to b4. But we're going to see that in the next video. For sure you should subscribe now in the channel in order not to miss the next videos. For that reason, he played this move, knight c to e7, and now we should open more lines to develop more of our pieces. How to do that? With this nice move d4. And this is another pawn sacrifice, but of course black doesn't dare to capture that, because then we can deliver a check here on e4, and this is destroy black's coordination, because black now doesn't have a good move. For example, after that we can capture the knight for free, right? And the material is equal, but the king is very badly placed here. For that reason, after d4, this is the idea behind d4, black should play something more passively and protect the knight, because this knight is under attack. Now we should develop the bishop on g5, a very strong move, because we pin the knight, on e7, we pin the knight on d5. We would like to capture one of the defenders in order to capture the other knight. Notice that the king is free now, and the white can castling long, right, and put the other rook in the center, and white have a very free development, and this is a fantastic attack. The computer assessed this position approximately to equal, but I guarantee to you, if you have this fantastic position in your games, then you can destroy your opponents. And one of possible replies is this h6, but of course we can deliver our idea. We can capture e7, bishop takes e7, and now you should not be in a hurry. You should continue with the development, because the enemy king is still there, and black have a lot of problems in order to develop their pieces. And you can see that that the main problem is that he cannot develop this rook on a8 because he has the bishop on c8 in between. He cannot develop the bishop because the king is there. The king is here to protect the knight on d5, and you can see something is really bad with black pieces. We have rook to f8 and now queen to e4. What is the threat? We would like to capture the pawn on e5, and it's very difficult for black to defend that pawn. For example, if he plays something like that in order to protect the pawn, then this knight on d5 is not very well protected because we are attacking this knight three times and we can capture the knight. And after that, for example, we can deliver a check here, and you can see white's attack is very strong. For example, after that we can capture the pawn, or he can go on d7. It doesn't change a lot because we will capture here. We're attacking the bishop. If yet the bishop goes away, then we have discover attacks like bishop takes b7, we're attacking the rook, the king, the queen is behind the king, and this is a very bad position for black. So I'm saving that in order to give you the PGN file. And during the game, after queen e4, black capture here on f2, and white capture on d5. This is the best move because it brings one more piece on this pinned knight on d5, and now it's almost impossible to protect that knight, and this is happening because black doesn't have good coordination with his pieces. And now he give a check here on g5, king b1, rook d2. He would like to exchange some of the attackers, but black's position is very bad. Of course, here we have a lot of ways to win. You are welcome to pause the video and try to think, to calculate something, because by calculating you will improve yourself. Don't see this video passively. Try to interact with the video. And of course, if you have any question, you are very welcome to pause a comment, and I'll be happy to reply and give you suggestions. Now, during the game, he played this move h4, very nice. He would like to remove the defender to kick away this bishop in order to capture the rook, but probably the best move here is to capture the rook immediately, and after bishop takes d2, now we have a very, very strong move. It was obvious to capture the rook, right, on d2, but I hope you foreseen this move. And the move is rook f1. What is the idea? For example, if he captures the knight here, we would like to deliver a checkmate. We can give this strong check on f7, on f5, and after king e7, we can deliver a final checkmate on f7. For that reason, this was the strongest move. This is another strong move to capture the knight immediately, and after this recapture, we can give a check on g6. And he can capture here on e5, but we can deliver another check, and you can see this is very bad if you have your king in the center, because the king should be protected by the pawns, like here, like the white king, because this is wide open. The black king is in the center of the board, and we can attack him. King d4, we can capture here, bishop takes d2, and now the queen joins the attack. King c5, queen b5, king d6, we can capture now the pawn. He can run away on c7, another check on b5, king b8, and now you can deliver the final checkmate. This is checkmate in two moves, and the correct move is queen e5. He can block this check once, but then we can deliver this checkmate. For that reason, going back here, we have a lot of good moves. The best is to capture the rook. The second best move is to capture on d5, but h4 is also a very nice move. He captured here, the black player captured on d1, this is a check, rook takes d1, bishop takes h4, knight takes d5. Finally, we destroy this blocker, the only defender in that position, and after c takes d5, we can capture this pawn with many ways, but white player take it with the bishop because he would like to deliver a check here on d6, a discover check. He also attacked the queen. We have queen to g5, rook d6 check, king e7, and now a nice move, rook g6, because he is attacking the queen. Queen doesn't have any good back rank check because he cannot jump in front of above the pawn. He cannot go on g1, and we're attacking the queen, we're attacking the g7, and the black's position is collapsing here. After queen to d2, we capture here, King f8, rook g8, another check. You can see white doesn't have a lot of pieces, but his pieces are coordinated fantastically. Black would like to give a check on d1 and deliver a checkmate, but he doesn't have any time because white is attacking first. And after king to e7, we deliver a checkmate, and the checkmate is by this move, queen h7. What was the important things here on this game? We have the fried liver attack after e4, e5, knight to f3, knight c6, bishop c4, aiming for the Italian game, and this is a possible line, knight to f6, and now you should go forward, knight g5, create the attack, and after this d5 move, you should capture the pawn. You are attacking the pawn, and after this recapture, you can sacrifice your knight, knight takes f7. And after king takes f7, you can deliver the double attack with the queen and deliver all these beautiful tactics. I hope you enjoy this video and hope to see you soon. All the best!